Hey everybody, PrintAQuest Skirmish has forever changed PrintAQuest, and that's good. However, it's left me with some problems as I've extended this idea to making maps with walls and things like that, and that's going to require me to do some thinking. In normal PrintAQuest, whenever you make a map, you just take the floor tiles and you snap them all together because they're blocks, but you leave some holes where the walls are going to be, and then the walls build up on that. And while that works, it wasn't a whole lot of fun to build, and I kind of wanted the process of building a map to be a part of the PrintAQuest experience. The difference in PrintAQuest Skirmish is that you start with a large flat panel and all your floor tiles just snap right onto that, and it is much more fun to build like that. Now, extending that idea to PrintAQuest where we have walls, it's real simple. The walls are now risen up on a little half block and they just snap right in there and they line up perfectly with the floor tiles. And then we can make all of the base tiles a little bit shorter, but then we can have slightly taller ones that go on top of it with potentially some decorations to make the dioramas of adventure that PrintAQuest is, but also enable you to quickly remove these so that you can have access to the pieces while you're playing. So that's good. However, the maps for PrintAQuest don't fit on a single large flat panel like the map for PrintAQuest Skirmish does, and that's bad. So the solution is that I'm going to have to figure out a way to make panels hold together, and this creates a bit of a problem. Initially, my thought was I'll just make sure that there's always something bridging across there to hold them in place. And while that would work, I don't want to do that. What I really want to do is make it so that we can snap them in on the side. But here's the problem. PrintAQuest panels are smaller than the PrintAQuest connectors. They're thinner than the PrintAQuest connectors. So if I put a regular connector hole in the side here, it would not work. So what's the solution here? Well, I could potentially make a thinner connector that looks like a PrintAQuest connector from the top, but from the side is much, much thinner. And if I take that hole and I put it in the side here, that will actually hold on well enough that they'll snap together. Now, my initial thought was that this would be so thick that there wouldn't be enough meat on the top and the bottom for the 3D printed, so I'd have to think about an open-faced version. But I tried it closed and it works actually really good as well, so that's good. However, this becomes the problem that we now have a new PrintAQuest connector that you have to keep a whole separate stock of, and it only has one purpose in the entirety of PrintAQuest, and that's bad. So what's my solution? Well, I've been thinking about this. Stay tuned for part two to find out.